Start the subcuticular suture by inserting a knot at the far end of the incision. Tie a standard reef knot and then cut the short end of the suture very short, as we're going to bury the knot. Then, using the forceps, carefully retract the skin edge. Take a small bite of the subcuticular material and pull the suture through. Then, on the opposite side of the wound, insert a similar subcuticular bite of the suture material and gently work up the wound, ensuring that each bite does not go too deep into the tissues. Each new suture must be inserted almost opposite the exit of the previous suture, and this ensures that as the suture material is tightened, it draws the wound edges together, almost in the manner of invisible mending. The accuracy of the placement of the sutures will ensure an equal tension down the wound and neatness of the closure. You can see here a needle going in just at the skin edge, taking a bite of the subcuticular tissues and coming out at the skin edge. At the end of the incision, the needle can be exited about a centimeter away from the edge, and then the needle reversed and passed back almost through the same hole in the skin in the opposite direction. This can be repeated, passing the needle through the same skin hole, back again, and then cut. For non-absorbable sutures, some surgeons like to use the collar and cuff technique. There is a crushed bead at one end, followed by a larger bead to stop the suture being pulled through the needle hole. Once the closure has been completed, a further bead and cuff are placed onto the suture end, and once the correct tension has been applied to the suture material, the metal bead is crushed using a substantial hemostat or bead crusher. We are now going to close the same incision using a continuous suture technique. Insert the first suture as before at right angles to the skin edge, and ligate this using a standard reef knot. However, in this situation, just cut the short end and hand the long end of the suture to your assistant, who will follow you during this procedure. The second suture is put in a standard manner as before, and then the suture snugged down and handed to your assistant. Here comes the third suture, the distance apart being exactly the same as for interrupted sutures. Work along the wound, each time ensuring the same tension, and then hand it to your assistant, who maintains that tension. Work along the wound, ensuring equal distance between the sutures, to ensure the same tension down the whole length of the incision. After the final suture has been inserted, leave one loop long and then ligate using a standard reef knot technique. Once this has been tied, you're in a position to cut both ends of the suture material. Matress sutures can be inserted to allow for eversion or inversion. They can also be used for irregular skin edges. We will demonstrate here a vertical matress suture. The suture is put in as you see in the standard manner. The needle is reversed, and then, taking just a small bite of the skin edges, the suture is completed and a reef knot tied. a second vertical mattress suture is inserted. The suture is placed. The needle then reversed in the needle holder, and then go back, taking just a few millimeters of skin edges. The knot is then tied and the suture material cut. Let's insert just one more vertical mattress suture, in at right angles. Reverse the needle, and then going back, just taking the wound edges as seen. We will now demonstrate the horizontal mattress suture. The initial suture is as before. Again, reverse the needle in the needle holder, but on this occasion move slightly horizontally and go back to the other side of the incision in a similar manner. One can see very clearly why this is called a horizontal mattress suture. Once again, the reef knot is tied in the standard manner and the suture material cut. We will now insert another horizontal mattress suture. The suture is inserted in the standard manner. The needle reversed and then returned to the opposite side of the wound parallel to the initial traverse. The suture is then secured with a reef knot. Both vertical and horizontal mattress sutures can be useful for ensuring eversion or inversion of wound edges, and this is clearly demonstrated by diagrams in your handbook. The difference between the vertical mattress suture and the horizontal mattress suture can easily be seen in this demonstration. We are now going to close the same incision using a continuous suture technique. Insert the first suture as before at right angles to the skin edge, and ligate this using a standard reef knot. However, in this situation, just cut the short end and hand the long end of the suture to your assistant, who will follow you during this procedure. The second suture is put in a standard manner as before, and then the suture snugged down and handed to your assistant. Here comes the third suture, the distance apart being exactly the same as for interrupted sutures. Work along the wound, each time ensuring the same tension, and then hand it to your assistant, who maintains that tension. Work along the wound, ensuring equal distance between the sutures, to ensure the same tension down the whole length of the incision. After the final suture has been inserted, leave one loop long and then ligate using a standard reef knot technique. Once this has been tied, you're in a position to cut both ends of the suture material.